Why do crazy people kill other people? What goes on in their lives? Well, people are trying to find out what was behind that terrible shooting in Washington that left 13 dead. And it looks like he was spending a lot of time watching video games.
Well, a new report says he was hearing voices and being treated for mental illness. Charlene Israel has that story.
A deadly shooting in the heart of the nation's capital.
We have an active shooter on the fourth floor.
The FBI says 34-year-old Aaron Alexis was behind the attack. He's identified as a civilian contractor and military veteran, and he had a valid pass and security clearance to enter the Navy Yard. But Alexis's motive is a mystery. Today, authorities are seeking the public's help.
We are looking to learn everything we can about his recent movements, his contacts, and his associates.
The father of the suspect once described his son as having anger management problems. And it turns out Alexis had a history of disturbing behavior. In 2010, he was accused of recklessly discharging a firearm into a neighbor's apartment. And in 2004, he confessed to shooting out the tires of another man's car. But Alexis was not a loner, and friends were shocked to hear he would go on a shooting rampage.
I actually believe that he did that anyway. So he's not that kind of guy to kill people.
Former roommates who lived with Alexis earlier this year in Texas say he was a practicing Buddhist, but they also say he was upset with the military since being discharged in 2011.
He just was upset with the government about all that and just very, he just felt slighted by his benefits and by what he was getting each month.
Friends also say Alexis was deeply into violent video games and could spend hours playing them. Meanwhile, the deadly shooting has reignited talk about gun control. On Capitol Hill, Senator Dianne Feinstein said, quote, "Congress must stop shirking its responsibility and resume a thoughtful debate on gun violence in this country." But not everyone agrees. Jesse Jane Duff of Concerned Veterans for America told CBN News that more laws aren't the answer.
Gun control laws only allow criminals to get a hold of the weapons, and those that are honorable people, such as like myself, wouldn't be able to defend ourselves. So that is a misnomer. It's just not even a fact-based argument.
It's still unclear how Alexis was able to get an assault-style rifle inside the Navy Yard. Security requires guests to pass through turnstiles watched by security guards before entering. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Well, once again, it shows how weak our defenses are. These are the soft targets, and for some reason, this is a military installation that some of the key figures in the United States Navy work. And it should have been guarded more carefully. They just let their guards down. But I agree with Ms. Duff, who said guns are not the problem. The problem is mental illness. This man was mentally ill, and he also was addicted to these violent video games. And those things can become addictive, and they can become life-altering, and they watch that, and suddenly that becomes their reality, and then if he has a little bit of anger, but the fact that he discharged a weapon a couple of times earlier, he should have been locked up. There should have been some order of restraint about him owning weapons. He should never have been allowed to get into that facility. They missed it in terms of screening. I mean, there are a whole lot of things that went wrong, but unfortunately, 13 people now lie dead because of it. Well, turning overseas, the United States is still working out its response to the crisis in Syria. John Jessup has that story from Washington. Here's John.
Pat, Syria's main opposition group is demanding a swift international response after a new report from the United Nations said there is clear and convincing evidence chemical weapons were used in Syria. But the highly anticipated report doesn't say which side is responsible for last month's attack. The U.S. believes the evidence shows it was the Assad regime. The U.N. report comes after the U.S. struck a deal with Russia to remove Syria's chemical weapons. President Obama has also cleared the way for some aid to assist the rebels. Well, the rains have finally ceased in Colorado. Good news as officials continue to search for the missing from the historic flooding there. Authorities say at least 8 people were killed by the deadly floodwaters. A week of torrential downpours also has left hundreds unaccounted for, and rescue teams are still trying to evacuate some of the victims. But other evacuees are returning and finding their houses utterly ruined. About 19,000 homes have been damaged or destroyed. Operation Blessing is on the ground there, working with local churches to help the victims. OB crews are also providing much-needed cleanup supplies, as well as prescriptions, diapers, and baby formula.
It's been so great to have Operation Blessing come to be a part of our community. We just don't have the resources and the wisdom that y'all have. You guys have been in so many different situations and disasters, and this is our first round. So we are so thankful for the wisdom that would come from Operation Blessing and organizations like yours that would bring relief.
Volunteers are also offering emotional and spiritual support through prayer. Pat?
John, the thing is that people want to help, and we're there. You know, the nice thing about Operation Blessing, we're there. When the crisis comes, we're there. We have emergency response teams that almost at the moment something like this happens, they show up. So if you want to participate helping those people in Colorado, it's Disaster Relief Fund, CBN Center, Virginia Beach, Virginia, 23463. And I might point out, we just don't come in, take pictures, and then leave. We stay and stay and stay. We're usually one of the first in, and we almost always the last to leave, because we like to help people. There was a good man in the United States Senate who's now retiring, and he will be missed by people like me. So John Jessup has that story.
Montana Democratic Senator Max Baucus is trying to simplify the tax code. Political and business leaders agree the code is complicated for individuals and too burdensome for businesses. Baucus is working with his Republican counterpart in the House, Dave Camp of Michigan. Baucus talked about the effort as the Montana Job Summit opened Monday with several thousand politicians, business people, and academics in attendance. Business leaders agree reforming the tax code would help America better compete in the global economy. Heroin use is on the rise. It was once a drug relegated to the homeless and rock stars, but now it's popping up at high school parties in the suburbs. Lori Johnson explains how heroin's popularity is directly related to the increase in prescription drug abuse.
Millions of American adults and teenagers are addicted to the prescription painkillers Vicodin and OxyContin, so much so that they'll do anything to get them, even kill. But finding the drugs and paying for them is harder and harder. Sometimes just one pill sells for $80. So addicts, like this woman, often switch to the painkiller's cousin, heroin, because it's easier to find, cheaper, and packs a bigger punch than painkillers.
If you hear about something that's like that, only 100 times stronger, you know, I can definitely see the appeal.
But the appeal fades quickly. Soon it takes more of the drug to get the same high, that feeling that becomes the only thing in life that matters.
It's horrible. It's horrible because you don't want to do it anymore, but you just don't really have any choice.
Rehab centers report a rise in heroin abusers, especially ones from middle-class homes, because heroin has become more available in places you'd never expect.
It's cheaper for kids. I mean, that, you know, because that's the question you ask. Why did you start with heavier drugs than alcohol? And most of them tell you it's easier to get than alcohol.
Therapist Linda Mental says there's only one way to break the bondage of heroin addiction.
This is not about willpower. You cannot will yourself off of this type of biological pull that is in the brain. So you really need to have something bigger than yourself and the transcendent power of God, the relationship with Christ, who is in you, who can help you, who can strengthen you to do all things, is absolutely necessary in any addiction treatment.
Mendel says people can die from a heroin overdose the very first time they use it. She recommends parents talk to their kids about the dangers of heroin and intervene if they see changes in their child's personality, weight, friends, or schoolwork. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
A growing number of drug-resistant superbugs are urgent threats to the public health in the United States. That's a warning from the Centers for Disease Control. Two of the worst threats include gonorrhea that's resistant to antibiotics and a bug that causes potentially life-threatening diarrhea. The bugs have been developing more resistance to drugs over time, and future drugs also may not be effective. The right diet, along with exercise and keeping stress under control, might actually help reverse the aging process. The study from the University of California at San Francisco found that a plant-based diet focused on vegetables, along with other changes, could actually affect telomeres. Those are part of the chromosomes that affect how cells age. Dr. Dean Ornish headed up the study. He says it's not the fountain of youth, but it is a step in the right direction. Pat, you're an excellent example of someone who's strong and healthy. What do you think is the secret to living long?
Well, it's choosing your ancestors wisely. That's the way. That's how it starts.
Thank you for that tidbit.
You've got to do that first. But these telomeres, they're a line of chromosomes, and they just chop off as you age, and when they chop, the ability to recreate the cells goes away. That's why this resveratrol was so hot, that it was supposed to bolster the telomeres. And I think the whole idea of plant-based, beans and corn and vegetables, fresh vegetables and fruits. Mm-hmm. Our diet, Terry, is awful. And I've been talking about this high fructose corn mm-hmm. syrup. Laurie did a study, went out and talked to people. He said, oh, no, that's not a problem. Now there's a new study coming out of Harvard, I believe, that says, yes, there's a definite link.
Oh, surely there's a problem.
Between, yeah. mm-hmm. But this stuff is not just like one sugar gram versus another sugar gram. These things have funny effects on people. And they've got what they call the metabolic syndrome, and it's something that is causing, it causes high blood pressure, and it causes insulin resistance. So your body, can't control the insulin, and it demands more and more insulin, and the insulin is flowing into your body, and this is causing diabetes. And so you've got all these terrible consequences of this stuff, and most of it is based by what we eat. So, in any event, yes, John, I'm going to live to be 100, so you just mark my word.
Egyptian security forces have retaken a town that's been ruled by radical Islamists since July 3rd. The city of Delga in the southern Minya province is home to more than 20,000 Christians. In the 11 weeks the Islamic militants ruled that city, they ransacked and burned churches and forced Christians to pay them protection money. At least two Christians who refused to pay the Islamic jizya tax were killed. One of the churches that was burned is believed to be more than 1,600 years old. The security forces arrested 56 people for assaults on police forces, as well as attacks on government and religious institutions. A Catholic priest is being treated at a Tanzanian hospital following an acid attack in Zanzibar. Police say the priest was badly injured in his face, chest, thighs, and legs. The attack occurred in a crowded part of town Friday afternoon. This is the fifth acid attack in Zanzibar since November. Just last month, an assailant threw acid in the faces of two young British women doing volunteer work. Police have yet to make an arrest in any of these attacks. Well, you can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.